Hi everybody, let's keep the fun rolling. In this video we'll be talking about mean reversion. It's another pretty simple strategy for trading stocks and other financial instruments. You'll see how it works the more we get into it, but it's similar to our rolling average, simple moving average strategy, but in reverse. So we're going to use Wife Finance. You guys know I'm a big fan of Wife Finance for building out these strategies and just testing out, what might not work. We're going to be using gold in this instance, and we're only going to be, we're going to be going for the last 10 years, and we're just going to grab the adjusted close. Data frame should look something like this. By the end of that, we're going to need to get our returns. We're just going to take the adjusted close divided by the last day's adjusted close. We're going to define our simple moving average as 25. So the last 25 days of our adjusted close will be our moving average there. We calculate the moving average just by taking the average of the last 25 of our adjusted close, right? So this is where it's sort of different from our simple moving average strategy. We're going to set a threshold, and the idea of this strategy is when our trend line gets above or below our threshold, that's when we'll put in a long or short position. So we define the trend line as our distance, and the distance is the adjusted close price minus our simple moving average data, right? So to plot that and see what it looks like, it looks something like this. So you can see our upper threshold here, our lower threshold here, and our zero neutral position here, right? So the idea is when the distance moves below the lower threshold, the idea is that the stock will eventually revert back to its average. So when we know it's past the threshold, we can set a long position and capture the profit here, right? As it comes back up, and vice versa. When the distance moves above the upper threshold, we have pretty clear confidence that it's going to revert back down at some point. And so we set a short position up here and move back down here, right? And we capture this profit here. When it's in here, like let's say we have a short position here, we don't wait for it to come back down past this threshold. We just have it come back down under the upper band, and we go back into market neutral. Otherwise, we just keep our position short until it drops back down below this upper threshold and vice versa. So we do need to set our position. And you can see here when trend line is greater than upper threshold, we go short and vice versa. And we'll go market neutral. For when we try to plot our position throughout time, we're going to fill in the gaps with zero. And let's plot what that looks like. So you can kind of see here earlier within the decade, we have several long positions. This is a long position. This is a short position. It's good to know what you're calculating here. So one is short, negative one is long. So yeah, this is what it looks like. There's several periods where we just stay market neutral. I mean, that's kind of a long time from 2014 all the way basically up to 2016. So we don't even put in a trade the entire time in 2015. So one could suggest that this isn't the most maybe active strategy, but it does work based on what we're looking at here, right? So actually, to determine if it works, we need to plot the returns against our strategy. And you can see that our strategy does outperform just the regular returns of the instrument with these, of course, long periods of no activity in between. So one could see that as a downside. One could see that as an upside, as you're just retaining, your profits here until the next trade. That's one of the benefits of algorithmic trading. You don't have to deal with the emotional, decision weight of whether or not you should make trades in this period outside of your strategy. Just let the algorithm do it for you. This was a really quick video. But there's not much more to say about it. I think, it's not much. Yeah, there's not much more to this strategy. It's fairly simple. It's, I think, easy to understand. You know, when it goes up here, sell it. When it goes down here, buy it. So, yeah, and I think it's solid logic. Just with this one downside, right, of these periods of non-activity. So anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll keep making other strategies like this. Hopefully we'll just keep doing fundamentals. And if you like it, let me know in the comments, like the video so I know what to make, and I hope to see you guys in the next video. Bye.